Rosemary Ndlovu was found guilty of killing 6 people. She is going to serve 6 concurrent life sentences. Imprisoned for life. The first person Ndlovu killed was her cousin, witness Madala Homi. He was hit with a blunt object on his head by a hitman hired by Rosemary. Just like the rest of her victims, she was the last person to see him alive and the first person to report him missing. Now this is when it gets sad. She insured him for 100,000 rand. It means she got to pocket 100,000 rand, but she only paid 200 rand for the funeral. Rosemary was a gambler. After she killed her cousin in 2012, she kills her sister in 2013 and pockets 700,000 rands from her life cover. Now that's twisted and evil, to kill your kin for 700,000 rands. The following year, it is alleged that she killed Maurice Mabasha, who was her lover. Same thing happens again. She mourns prematurely. She pocketed 500,000 rands from her lover's life policies. Fourth victim in the murdering spree is Zanele Mota. She dies in 2016. Rosemary pockets 120,000 rands in policies. She dies of sustained internal injuries and broken ribs. Zanele Mota's brother is a fifth victim. His name was Mayeni Mashaba. She was found dumped in 2017 in Olandsfontein. When the police checked the phone records, the last person to call Mayeni was Rosemary. After killing her sister Audrey in 2013, it is alleged that she played a part in killing Audrey's son, her nephew, Brilliant Mashego. The phone records of Brian Mashego show that she was with his aunt Rosemary the day before he died. Rosemary pocketed 4 million rands in insurance from all the victims. Criminologist Lieutenant Almeria told the court that Rosemary Ndlovu married at the age of 18. Unfortunately, her husband passed on in 2004 and her son John T passed on at the age of 13. Now that has not stopped Rosemary's family to suspect that Rosemary had a hand in both their deaths, because they make a point. Why is it that death seems to follow Rosemary? Rosemary's husband died of illness and their son died of suspected poisoning. The murdered Maurice Mabasa and Rosemary had a child, Makanani. After Mabasa's death, Makanani moved to stay with Mabasa's mother. 2 weeks before Makanani passed on, she was fetched by her mother, Rosemary. She passed on days later in hospital. She was 2 years old. Rosemary Ndlovu has denied everything. She said she did not kill, plan to kill, or defraud anyone. But the judge said otherwise. The criminologist Almeria testified in court that even if Rosemary can go free from prison, there's a possibility that she will kill again, because it is suspected that she might have some unique mental illness. Remember, the sting operation was done when Rosemary hired a hitman to kill her remaining sister and mother and her nephews and cousins. And she almost killed her entire family in one go. She could have burned them alive. So definitely I agree with Colonel Almeria that if she were out in the society, Rosemary Ndlovu is capable of repeating the same thing. And it is possible that maybe she is schizophrenic. Then it will explain why she will have multiple personality. Because one personality is of kindness, colleague, a police officer. Then the other personality is opposite of that, where she's playing a part in the murder of people. And the unfortunate part here, it's killing. And sometimes you can see she's play acting in court. One moment before the guilty verdict comes, she's remorseful, she's crying, she says she hasn't done anything, she feels so sorry. There are tears in her face. As soon as the judge leaves his courtroom, then she goes to the family and say, you know what, I'm gonna see you, I'm gonna get you next year, in a threatening voice. There you are, South Africa's first woman serial killer. South Africa has been making headlines, international headlines, for the wrong reasons this year. At the beginning of the year, it was the Thembisa 10. And now, we not only have a serial killer, but a woman, which is very, very unique. So on the comment below, I'd like to hear your take on why South Africa is just making these unique headline stories, bad ones. Thanks for watching. Bye.